Hello guys, welcome to Agile Art. Today we'll be learning how to do abstract flowers using palette knife. So the final output looks like this. If you want to know how I achieved this, then please keep on watching. I've painted the canvas background with a metallic copper shade. I've chosen this color so that the foreground, which is the tree and the flowers which will be upcoming in the video, will stand out for this background. I've written down a tree roughly as you can see, and I'm going over the drawn tree with burnt sienna shade. Now I'm loading my palette knife, as you can see here, the edge of the palette knife, with two colors mixed, which is burnt sienna and white. More of burnt sienna, we could say 70% burnt sienna with 30% white. I've loaded the edge of the palette knife. With this slight amount of pressure, you can go on and keep on creating textures like this, which will give the bark of the tree a 3D effect, as you can see in the video. Don't apply too much of pressure here, otherwise your paint will appear as too much spread out and will not have the 3D appeal to it which you're actually trying to achieve. Go with the slightest amount of pressure. Just roughly touch the board with the paint loaded. So in order to achieve this effect, you should not put much pressure. Putting not much pressure is the key, guys. So in the upcoming step, we'll be painting petals with the help of the same palette knife. I've taken pink mixed with little amount of white. You can take any color of your desired choice. So I've loaded the palette knife, as you can see, with pink color mixed with white. The white what I've used here is not your normal titanium white. I've used a heavy body acrylic white from Camel for this purpose. The reason for using a heavy body acrylic is, so even after the paint dries up, this 3D effect, whatever you're seeing on the petals right now, that will remain intact if you use a heavy body acrylic. With medium or light body acrylics, what happens is that the same desired effect, the same 3D effect what you try to achieve even after the paint dries, that might not be the case if you're using any other paint other than your heavy body acrylic. That's the whole purpose of heavy body acrylic. So it will retain the texture even after the paint dries up. A hack if you do not have a heavy body acrylic, considering heavy body acrylics are a little bit pricier compared to the normal acrylics what we use for our painting purposes on a day-to-day basis. You can also might do with Camel texture white if you have one, or any texture white from any other brand, or even your mixed media paste also you can do in order to achieve this. No worries if you do not have either of these, you can might as well go with the normal titanium white, mix it with the color of your choice, whatever you wish to do for the petals. But just keep in mind, the texture after the paint dries up is different what you get in terms of your normal acrylic versus your paint mixed with either a heavy body acrylic or a texture white. That's the only difference, absolutely no other difference, trust me. So you have to load the palette knife, keep it on the canvas, press and drag is the key. Okay, so Camel cone liner I've used here in the shade yellow, going on with the center of the flower in order to achieve this highlighted look. This is an optional step because I had it and had purchased it recently. I've used it in this. If you do not have this, you can either again load the edge of the palette knife and go on the center of the petal with the yellow shade, or you can just skip the step as well, as per your choice. So the key for achieving the 3D effect of the flowers is making use of a heavy body acrylic paint or a texture white paste. So load the edge of the palette knife with a good amount of the paint. So do not shy away from using good amount of paint, because that is what ultimately gives the 3D effect what you are trying to achieve. So I have used Viridian mixed with light green and a hog hair brush in order to achieve the grass-like texture. So this is the final output, guys. Thank you so much for tuning into Agile Art. Please do hit on the like button and please do comment and let me know your thoughts on what you'd like to see in the upcoming videos.
Please do subscribe to Agile Art if you haven't yet, and do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates from me. Thank you.